right here, we have got an ash tree that's on the ground, so we're going to start with ash dieback. Ash dieback is here, so they're having to do something about it, particularly in the areas where there's quite a high footfall, a lot of visitors. So obviously the trees do need to be managed. It is dependent on where your trees are. I mean, do you have ash trees in your garden?
We have ash trees
not
there,
in our garden, but loads near. Around
in
us.
The area,
just
yeah.
Up the road, and we have noticed evidence of dieback.
Two things that we want to cover here, so horse chestnut leaf miner, which most of you will have at least seen if not heard the name, and then also horse chestnut bleeding canker.
Members of the public can prevent the spread of pests and diseases by making sure that they're not moving contaminated material around with them. So contaminated material can be anything such as water or soil or leaf litter that has some sort of pest or disease living within it. There are two good strands of good biosecurity. On a personal level, it's literally making sure that you're keeping it clean. One way that members of the public can reduce moving this material around with them is by cleaning off their kit, so that can include their shoes or their bike tyres or buggy tyres, cleaning them between different sites that they visit. But then from another perspective, you need to think about it on a bit of a larger scale, more of an international scale.
Yeah.
And that's where you're thinking about where your plants are coming from. Where have those trees come from? Were they grown in the UK? Have they come from a pest-free area or not?
When you're buying your planting stock, think about where you're getting them from, so the nurseries that you're buying them from. Ask them if they've got a biosecurity policy, ask to see it. We do a lot of work with industry to make them aware of the different measures that they can adopt to try and reduce the risk of spreading pests and diseases. It's very much about working together, it's a joint responsibility.
So it's really important for landowners and managers to be aware of the pests and diseases that could be affecting their trees. So the first thing they need to do is do an assessment of what tree species are actually on their site, because by knowing what tree species are on their site, they will know what risks are being posed to them.
As members of the public, but also industry professionals, landowners, land managers, it's important that you're aware of the tree stock around you, whether you manage it, whether it's a woodland that you're visiting. And if you do see anything that looks suspicious, please do report it through our Tree Alert online reporting tool.
At the end of the year, and then regrow them the following year, they have, you know, fresh, clean leaves.
Please be aware that there may well be pests or diseases present within that woodland or forest. Certain areas of the woodland may be sectioned off with notices advising you to stay out of that particular area.
Each mark, each bit of damage is an individual larva, so it's quite a heavy infestation then.
Yes. So we work quite closely with the Forestry Commission to make sure the information is correct, and we also are lucky enough to have plant health experts from the Forestry Commission come here and talk to the public about tree pests and diseases.